guys seen kids around here spray painting or not?
No.
Nah, you guys didn't call about it?
No.
Alright, just making sure. Look at these folks.
Yeah.
Philly, the city of brotherly love, the home of many firsts, from the cheesesteak to the very first computer. A city recognized today for its beauty, but one that wasn't always so beautiful. You see, like every city, there's the good and the bad. With over 3,500 murals depicting stories both bad and good, from the young and old, one platform that has always been used to tell stories throughout the decades is the walls. You see, the average eye wouldn't be able to tell, but to a writer, the walls speak volumes. In the earlier days, we can go back to as far as cavemen, even the Egyptian empires, when human civilization used hieroglyphics to tell stories on the walls. But in this chapter of history, we're gonna focus on the mid-1900s, after the American Revolution, when soldiers, rioters, and other people would tell stories and mark them on the walls. A time when even gang members marked their territories using graffiti. In many cases, political activists would use graffiti to give them a voice. It wasn't until the early 1960s when Philadelphia natives known as Cornbread and Cool Earl wrote their name all over the city, gaining attention from the community and local press. Shortly after, throughout the following decades to pass, many writers were born who contributed vital growth to the culture. Every generation inspired the next, which gave birth to a new era. It's like the earlier version of graffiti, but on steroids. A culture and lifestyle taken so seriously, yet people know so little about. Graffiti to some will be considered vandalism. To others, it will be considered art. You know what they say, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Well, I guess the same rule applies here. But the truth of the matter is that art is expression or application of human creative skill and imagination, typically in visual forms such as a painting, sculpture, producing works to be appreciated primarily for their beauty or emotional power. You can pause that and rewind it if you need to. But basically, the application of human creative skill or imagination, primarily for their beauty or emotional power. Now look around in everyday society. Read what subliminally passes many consciences daily. Messages from outspoken anonymous patriots of this country. The rebels who roam the streets day or night, ready to lead a march. Stories depicted and not taken credit for. Neighborhoods and cities both strategically graphed, but then erased the next morning. What you're about to see is an original story, straight out of Philly. But you're not gonna hear it from me. I have a series of artists, both young and old, here to paint a better picture for you. Now sit back, grab your black book, and apply the creative skill, because although graffiti is worldwide today, Philadelphia is graffiti in its very essence. So sit back and enjoy.
I write bark and shit. Bark, I've been writing it for like more than 30 years. I used to write bar, but some kid and shit, I was writing that shit, so I was like, man, I can't keep writing that shit, somebody already got it. So I just added the K to it, and I took off from there, you know what I mean? The first time I ever snuck on the train and shit, and I seen them rooftops and shit, you know what I mean? I seen all the colors up there, that's what inspired me, all the colorful shit that was on the roof. Writers that inspired me was like JC, Estro, Raz, MB, RH, Pep, EC Car, RH, all them dudes, you know what I mean? Everybody that was doing the rooftop back in the day. That's, you know, where I got my, you know what I mean? Like, my love for art came from them, for the Graff. I like paint, because when you work with paint, you can, like, when you mess up on something, you can always go back over, you know what I mean? It's like having an eraser, but instead of having it in the form of rubber, you got it in the form of ink. And, you know, that's why I like it. And the way it hits the wall, and, the pigment, like I love the pigment of the colors, and they pop, you know what I mean? If you make them pop, they're gonna look bright. I like the stock cap. You know what I mean? But you know, if I go bombing, like doing regular hands everywhere, yeah, I go take a fat cat, but I can also get down with a stock cat, you know what I mean? So all that exposing me shit ain't gonna happen. Because I've been in the game for too long. Yeah, this was one of the joints I freestyled like a week ago, week and a half ago. I mean, it took us like 3 days to do it, because it was fucking cold as shit. But we got it done, you know what I mean? And that's all that matters right now. Man, we just come up with it as we paint. We paint and then we just start saying we're gonna do this, then we're gonna do that, and then the wall is done. You know what I mean? That's what we do and shit. That was like at least 8 cans. You know what I mean? And like probably half of the paint wasn't even wasted. You know what I mean? Like, you know, after I paint the next one, I would say, okay, this one is better than the last one, you know. They get better every time, you know what I mean? Well, Graff is like, in a way, a savior. Straight up, because I could have been doing worse shit, you know what I mean? By me painting on the wall, it keeps me away from the fucking street. You know what I mean? So if I'm painting 5 hours here, that means I'm avoiding 5 hours in the fucking slums and shit. So it's keeping me away from that shit. And when I'm done here, I go the fuck home. Cause you know, I don't play the streets like that. I just come out here to paint and go the fuck home.
What up, it's your boy Rame, KMD. Keep making dollars, causing mad destruction. Badlands, what's up? Man, I got my name when I was a young buck, man. You know, the different influences, you know what I'm saying? But they used to call me Raymond a lot. So, you know, that kind of stuck with the Rame name. Oh man, I remember when I was small, man, I used to get on the trains and just ride the train and just look at all the rooftops, all the care rooftops. That really influenced me to want to get in Graff. But what got me into getting hands was when I started hanging with KMD, when I started, you know, being around Rakan, you know, being around them type of dude, Sizer, rest in peace, Empire, shout out to Krev. When I started being around them, it made me, you know, start working on my shit and get my shit better. Cause you know, everybody in KMD had a man. If you write graffiti, man, you gotta be either in it for the right reasons or you just in it cause you just wanna fucking write. Like, I'm in it for the history of this shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I remember I went down in the tunnels and I looked at the walls like 3 or 4 times before I took the tag. Cause I didn't wanna write over no old head. So you know, that's what history is to me. I like when a writer uses his techniques into his hands. Like, you know, like when they writing and they whipping it and you see the fades, like, you know, it takes work to do that. Like, yeah, I mean, that's wrist work. A lot of people don't understand that. When you whip them letters and you bring up the fades and all of that, You gotta whip the can and all of that. So when the writers I like are writers to do that. You know, writers that you see when they whip the cans, that the fades go up, like, you know what I mean? Because they're using their technique into it. They're not just going up to the wall writing whatever they want. They're actually, you know, applying a technique into their style. And you can see it all in the whips, all in the clutches and the wickets, you know what I mean? So that's style to me, and that's what I look to in a writer. To tell you the truth, man, you know, the Graff game, I truly believe that you gotta evolve in it. Like, you might start doing stiff hands, then you do tall hands, then you do wickets, then you start doing throw-ups, then you start doing straight letters, then you start doing pieces. So me, I like it all. Like, I wanna try to master all that shit. But my preference is being in the streets fucking shit up. Wickets is my preference. Keep a mean streak on you, you know what I mean? The mops, I really don't like mops. Like, if I'm going on a route, I'll take a mop with me. But that walking around with a mop, I don't really like getting all that shit all over my clothes. But my favorite shit is spray paint, man, for real. Like, I'm not even, like, I never been a paper ball. Like, I don't really write on paper. Like, if you see my shit on paper, you'd be like, what the fuck? Like, I strictly went to the walls with it. Graff played a big part in my life, man, because I remember when I was a young buck, when I used to sneak out my crib to go writing, I would escape reality, man. It was like that Superman character, you know what I mean? When you leave your crib, you throw on that, you know what I mean? You throw your shit on, your bummy shit, and you become that character that's on the walls. So, you know what I'm saying? That was my shit, you know what I mean? I changed into a different person when I came out bombing. I wasn't this, you know what I mean? I was a whole different character when I came out after 12 o'clock.
To me, graffiti is a lot of things. It's art, a way of releasing stress. It's you know, putting your name in the world, you know, that. You know, that billboard that people have, their monikers, a name of McDonald's or Wendy's. My brand, my graffiti name is my brand, you know what I mean? But graffiti is the art. Graffiti is the name of art. It's one of the five elements of hip hop. It's you know, the five elements. The original five elements is b-boying, DJing, MC, graph writing, and the lost art of beatboxing. I would see the art, I would see the movies, you know, Wild Style, Breaking, you had so many things, you know, Tracy 168 did the Wild Style thing, and you had Breaking, you had Electric Boogaloo, you had, man, so many movies out there, yeah. Look how quick I did that with the ink. Yeah. But now I know where my letters and my stuff are going. This is actually a different E. If you look at this, this is a lowercase E, but it's also a bigger case E. But then you also have another E here. Got your R dropping in, coming in through here. You got your Krenz coming in through here. And I don't know if you see those letters, but that's your K, that's your R, this is your E, this is the N, and that's a Z. You know, I was all over the place. It was second nature. It was second nature to hip hop. I mean, like, you know, all the walls were wrecked. You know, the art was up there, Den was up there. You know what I'm saying? Mo, you had Zash, Cadism, Boza. I mean, I can go down a list of names of all these people. You know, I looked up to Curse, of course, my mentor. Delta, he was Delta. When I moved back into this area, that's when I first, like, met him and his style. And Spell, Sam, Ham, Scheme, Far, all these guys, man. These guys I looked up to. You had Irks, you know, Disco Duck, list goes on, you know. You got one style. You got so many styles. And you could take that and run with it so many different ways, scriptive. You know. Now you could eventually go from your tags and your different styles. And I created my own bubbler out of bubbles. I like to do bubbles on them. So why not bubble letters be made out of bubbles?
I'm from North Philly and West. My name is SPD, Supreme Puerto Rican Destroying. Where'd I get the name from? Back in high school, in 10th grade, I used to chill with, you know, a bunch of graph writers. And I started off with Spade. Then, you know, I mean, that's a common name, but to this day, everybody called me Spade. So then what I did was I shortened it out, put SPD. Then after that, I gave SPD a meaning, and to this day, I've been rocking with it ever since. Graffiti has its own culture. As soon as somebody says graffiti, I think of, it's like an underground. It's like, it has its own, like, we have our own, like, little government, you can say. Like, it's weird, it's just weird. You would, in order to understand it, you would have to actually be a real part of it. You would have to know your history, go to the meetings, and you'll see, like, you know what I mean? It's its own world. For the people that really know me, they know I can piece and they know I can do the throw-ups, but I leave that on paper. I have, you know, my own personal opinion. I like putting my hands on the walls, whether it be a wicked or my stamp. I try to keep it simple so that the new cats can read it, and then sometimes you have to switch it up, you know what I mean? Show, you know what I mean, that you're not simple sometimes. You gotta be a little fancy sometimes with the wickeds and with the variation of hands, you know what I mean? But I stick with my stamps. You know what I mean? I grew up around A&W West. I pretty much, you know, grew up with KMD, TMH. I used to chill with Sires all the time. And the first thing he told me was, if you come out with a stamp and you hit up on the wall on the highway and somebody's going like 80 miles an hour, as soon as they see your stamp, they don't have to stare at it. They'll automatically know it's you. So I kept that in mind, and now when I put my stamp up, I make sure that it can be seen. If you're going on a motorcycle 120 miles an hour, somebody's gonna see it, you know what I mean? And as soon as they see it, all they have to do is use the peripheral. Oh, that was an SPD tag back there. Oh shit, you know what I mean? Next time I pass by, I know it's there, I'll flick and send it to them. Or they'll hit me up and be like, yo, I just saw you, you know what I mean? A couple of your hands down 5th Street or something like that. But my twist is the cans. They ain't nothing like it. Whether it be stock with stock caps, fat caps, it doesn't matter to me. I mean, I used to make my own tools. I used to make my own mops with deodorant bottles. Shit, I've even fucking written on fucking taxis with fucking candle wax. Just grabbing the candle, splitting that shit in half, and you know what I mean? Writing on fucking windows with that shit. When I route, I don't think of smashing a neighborhood. I don't think of just catching people's eyes. I barely go out as it is anyway. What I do is I make sure that my hands are gonna live. I mean, you have people like that'll smash neighborhoods like Rame. You know what I mean? When I go out, I don't smash neighborhoods. I go out and I try to get the highest spot possible, no matter how I gotta climb it, so that the buff can't reach it. Not only that, I'll catch shit that the buff can't buff. There's certain things the buff can't buff, and I'll catch that because I already know what they can't buff. So since I know that tip, I might as well use it. You go to different parts of the city and you can tell from going there, okay, you know, this cat must be from West Philly, because you can tell the way his wicked is formed. You can go to North Philly and be like, all right, you know, that's how they do their wickets. You can go downtown, and downtown is like a mixed pot, because there's out-of-towners that have come, and they're introduced to downtown first, whether it be by coming from the airport, the train, the Greyhound bus, and that's just a mixed pot. You know what I mean? They have their own style. I love bombing in the winter. I don't know what it is. It's just your fingertips freezing. It's just the whole experience.
Bold, B-O-L-D. Been riding since 2002, 13 years. And I always liked to draw and shit, man. I mean, so ever since I started seeing graffiti and shit on walls and shit, I thought that shit was hot and shit. So I mean, I just started grabbing markers and shit, writing Bolo and shit, until I met Solo and shit. That's what really put me on into this shit. You know what I mean, ever since I met him and shit, we had a little altercation and shit, but I mean, about the names and shit. So I mean, Bolo Solo, that shit was little, ain't funny. So I mean, I switched it to Bold and shit. I put a D into that shit. And ever since, I've been rocking out with that. Bark, my old head, man. Bark. I mean, Bark, Solo, Kid, Hothead, all them people, man. Now's a new generation, man. Everybody, I mean, a lot of names out there, man. But those were really, I mean, people I look up to and shit. I like markers, cans and shit, man. I need to paint and shit, man. I'd rather use the paint and shit, man. I'm good with the paint. It's all about that can control. It's just another world and shit, man. Everything just blurred out and shit, man. I don't think about shit, man. Just getting my name up and I keep it moving. But I mean, just the rush, man. That shit crazy. I mean, just the rush. Getting my name up and shit, man. That's it. Other than that, I'm blurred out. I take about four cans, but that's when I'm by myself. I'll probably run through like 2.5 by myself. But I mean, when I'm going out with somebody, I take about 8 to 10 cans and shit. We run through that about like 5-6 hours. But when I'm by myself and shit, you catch me like 4 cans. I'm always by myself though, you know what I mean? Fifth Street, man. I start from Fifth and Berks, and I just walk my way up and shit. I mean, to like pass the bully and all that, come back down 6 in between and shit. But other than that, when I'm on myself, Fifth Street, I love Fifth Street. You know what I mean? Sixth Street, Lehigh, all in between and shit. But when I'm with somebody else and shit, you know what I mean? We everywhere and shit, man. I mean, it's till like 6 in the morning and shit, strong. Book bags and all.
I'm in KIW, queen in war, kicking it wicked, cause I wanna, cause I'm a woman. Karma is wild, Wu-Tang Clan. Before I started writing Karma, I used to write my name, and then I knew Agua at the time, and Agua told me I needed to switch it up and start writing something else, and I came up with Karma, just because I like the letters. When I'm writing, it's on. I want to get everything. I want every tag to be hotter than the one before it. I want to keep going. I want to hit every single thing. I want rallies. I want to see my name on everything. I like using flat black rusto and doing tall hands and wicked. I like seeing a hand that's big and bold and crispy. On a route, well, since I came back out, I've been using about 10 to 20 cans a night, especially if I'm with Cat. I just keep it going, the paint just keeps flowing. I write all night till the sun comes up. Go back around and look at all my tags. Graffiti writers live two different sides, you got two different lives. So for me, you know, it's hard keeping up with the different personalities. You know, you're one person when you're writing and you're another person when you're not. I'm the queen in war, but X and tags and all that, that's corny. You wanna come at somebody, have a verse. Go hand for hand, go head to head with somebody on a wall and see what you got. Well, we got scraps, golden rule, never write in front of anybody. That's number one. Number two, I don't like to hit a wall with anybody on it. I want my name to stand out and be bold and don't crowd. My style is mine. It represents me. First tip you gotta have is stay in your books. Work on your hand, and you gotta practice. You gotta keep going, don't stop. You gotta do it every single day. Karma stands for constantly and relentlessly master in anything. I'm a tagger, first and foremost and always.
Cat, K-I-W. I like Cat. That's basically how I got my name. You know, growing up, cats all around the crib all the time. My best friend, president of the club, K-I-W, he wrote Donald Nasty. And that's basically what made me start writing. I wanted to be part of it. And once I took my first hit, that was it. Once I found the name and it fit me, I ran with it. You know, late 70s, 78, 79. I didn't start getting rep to like early 80s though. I like anything I can write my name with. I like them all the same. Marker, paint, roller, etch. Anything that I can put my name down with, I like it. I'm basically a fiend for writing. If crayon, if I had a crayon, I'd use that. It don't even matter. As long as I can put my tag down, I like it. I don't like a lot of scribble scrabble. I don't like a lot of stuff in the middle of people's name. I like it to be understandable, legible, uniform, and you know, I like all the points to point one way, the round one way, the fade one way. You know, for me, just a legible, nice hand is good for me. It's the letters. You know, if you make a certain letter or letters original, it adds so much to your name. You know, like for me, like my T is like crazy, you know, and everybody knows that that's my T. So anything that's duplicated or looks like it, they'll say that's Cat's T right there. He got that from Cat. So, you know, for me, just, you know, original letters for me. You don't necessarily have to have every letter original, but you know, everybody has their own style and flow. Graff was the one thing that I could do and I could do good. And couldn't nobody say anything about it because my name was my name and my rep was my rep. And I didn't write for anybody but myself. Well, because from time to time I write so big, I like the fattest cap on my can, you know, because I write so big, you know, the bigger the better. I had to teach members of my club that, you know, when you join KIW, you gotta be able to write big. If you used to write small, it's no more small writing. You either go big or you go home. And that's the phrase of the day. I'm high. Writing is like the ultimate high. Everything belongs to me. Anything I write on, anything I touch is mine. It's like everything is one big piece of paper for me to write on. And every neighborhood I go to is like turning the page on the book,
to write my name again.
I like looking at Graff ever since I was a little kid. You know, a 56 bus used to be a 56 trolley. I used to ride the trolley with my mom. And I used to ask my mom, you know, what does that say? Can you read it for me? You know, and my mom, you know, sometimes she would be like, you know, it says graffiti. You know what I mean? And like, I'd be like, you know, I knew in my head it didn't say graffiti, it was graffiti. But like, even at a younger age, it was like one of the first words I even knew how to spell. Like, it's kind of odd, you know what I mean? Like, I was so intrigued by it. Back then, this area in the Northeast was totally bombed, you know what I mean? You know, so like, that, just like, the way the walls look, the whole landscape, you know, inspired me, you know, to start, you know, writing, like, you know, just writing on paper from like, you know, first grade, second grade on, you know what I mean? I started writing BLE, Boosting Life Earnings, in 98. It took me a long time to get, you know, the script style up. Plus, I was involved with other dumb shit. I didn't get serious, you know, until about, honestly, about 5 years ago. They told me to put my shit down. They told me, once you wait a year till you start writing that on the walls and shit. But I ignored them. You know, I kept writing that shit on the walls, and, you know, eventually, you know, the BLE is kind of a hard genre for the wicked, you know, but, you know, I started doing the Prince and Prince Paul, and just kind of morphed into the Prince, you know what I mean? I dropped the Paul, and, you know, Lee wasn't really, you know, so he wasn't really complimenting my skills, you know what I mean? This is the city where you don't gotta drop one piece to be king, you know? You know, like, look at Cad, you know what I'm saying? I think it benefits you very well, you know, like, for example, a cat like NM, who could do it all, you know what I mean? So, like, but for me, it's the vomit aspect, the wickeds, the tall print, you know, script. I think, you know, if you just have one nice stamp, tall print, you know, it goes a long way. Taking something and just tweaking it, like being original with it, you know what I'm saying? And being yourself, not afraid to be yourself. That's a big thing with this. Not afraid to be yourself at all, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people will try to, you know, say, no, don't do it like that, do it like this. But if everybody sticks to the same format, you know, you ain't progressing. And, you know, we're in this shit for progression, you know what I mean? Whew, I mean, it's a relationship killer. Don't get me wrong. I mean, but that aside, Graff is like my most therapeutic thing right now, you know? It has been ever since I seriously picked up the cans and went on an all-city level. It's like, you know, sometimes it's like to blow steam off. You know, I do it when I'm happy. I do it when I'm sad. And then, you know, it's just like, I love the fact of like, you know, going by and seeing that shit the next day. You know what I mean? It's like, the thoughts should go down before you hit the wall. You should never go to the wall with a black mind. That's the worst thing you can do. You know what I mean? I made that mistake early on, and I, you know, progressed with it. When you're just getting that hit on the wall, it's pretty much just like, just be like, you know, just going through the motions of something you do every day. You know what I mean?
Section of North Philly. Marines is like 02, about a good solid 12 years.
I was writing Rame. That was my first name. That's what everybody knows me as. R-A-N-E. You know, that stuff for Rumble Nigga every day. That's all I did in, you know, my middle school and early high school days. What happened was, it was a good, there was a nice, he was well known around the area, Bull Rail, and then, you know, a couple people that's name was similar, and people was just saying, you know, when I started getting up in my neighborhood, people were saying I was like Dickie and I was hating and shit like that. So, you know, I mean, ain't nobody gonna write Dick either. So, you know, I took that hating thing and I ran with it, you know, cause I love hate. That's one thing I do. I love the hate. It's like, it's so flattering. You know what I'm saying? It's a difference of like, you know, you I don't know, like you being above somebody. It's like, if you hate them, it's like you barely, even if you is, you ask yourself, like, is we above anybody? Especially in this grab shit, because that's what's so great about this lifestyle. No matter if you got money, no matter, you know, if you a fucking a racist, handicapped, whatever, this grab shit, these walls don't discriminate. You understand? You think you nice or you not. I started writing with NEC, WA, so you know, my old heads, Lace, Gusky, Styles. But you know, outside of that, it was, you know, a bunch of people, Rain, KMD, Rakan, Kid, you know, High Head, Sus, you know, all them cats in my area today. You know, Peka was a big influence. I think the piece, and I think is you know, the hardest part to me. It was my hardest part of my heart, my biggest difficulty. But I think everything is a work in progress. You know, there's some people who could piece their ass off, but you know, they can't throw up a hand for shit. You know, and that's where I first started off, was straight hands, you know, raw. You know, all that peace and shit to me, with that shit was, you know, half of it was legal anyway. You know, I'm out on the street getting dirty, so, you know, I'm just throwing up hands and quick throwies and shit. I barely ain't do feelings and all that. I was just, you know, throwing shit up because I had to get up and get out. My favorite type of hand style is for one-liners. You know, one-liners and wickets, you know. But, you know, simple Philly shit. Be artistic. That's the only thing I can tell a graph writer that wants to do it now, is to explore the artistic aspect of graph, and not the aspect of just destroying. That's what I come to, you know, to admire about that, about the lifestyle now, the art of it.
LR, I'm from right here, you know, between 16th and Lehigh, 18th and Cumberland. You know what I mean? You know, I've been in the trap all day. Same old shit, man, you know, just trying to make it out this joint. You know what I mean? It was just Lil Rock because my dad is Big Rock, you feel what I'm saying? So, and I look just like my pops, so everybody used to call me Lil Rock. So, you know, that just became my name, Lil Rock. But then, you know, I switched to Lehigh Rock because, you know, that's my block, Lehigh F. So, you know, that's where the name came from. My cousin used to write CY back in the day, like up Germantown and shit like that. He used to have me on route with him because he had to babysit when I was a kid. So, you know, I used to go out with him in like the late 80s and shit like that. And I was always watching him write his name up on the wall. And, you know, that kind of like influenced me a little bit like that. I like this stuff. But then, you know, so I just, you know, just started practicing like in the 90s. Then, you know, and I just developed, you know, LR, I mean, spell it out, Lehigh Rock, Lil Rock, you feel what I'm saying? It stands for numerous things. Like, what kind of inspired me? My man Bam, it's in my old head that writes Sex, T.O.P. You know what I mean? Like, me and Rame, Used to go at it in the books back in the day in high school, like in 95, 94, and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Because he was able to piece and stuff like that. And I like that type of stuff, so I'm like, you know, I like this game, so you know, I'm gonna try to master it the best way I can. You know, so bad, Kev, catching the L, saying Kev shit all on the L rooftops. Like a lot of local dudes, my man JSB around the corner. So you know, Corey Rock around the corner, rest in peace, that's my old head. I mean, just a lot of dudes, man, you know. Like a lot of dudes I hang around, they ask me right. So it's like, you know, me seeing them, I have to throw their shit up. So I'm like, fuck it, I'm just throwing my shit up. But I ain't really never throw my shit up on the wall until I was decent. Because I ain't want to throw them the bullshit on the wall and get clowned. Because, you know, in my era, if you throw some bullshit on the wall, you'll get clowned for some bullshit that they see on the wall. So, you know, I mastered my craft, and that's when I started hitting the walls crazy. I love wickets, clean wickets. A clean stamp. As you can see, this right here, this a little wicked right here, but it's clean because you can read it. You feel what I mean? So that's clean to me. Like Drama, Rasad, Catism, Boza, you know, SA from the 4080s, stuff like that. Like when you do a wicked, like as you see my man Miko, I saw my young boy Wreck, and you see my shit. You feel what I'm saying? That we all in the same club, WCS, but you can read everything. You feel what I mean? Clean. I love looking at wicked because it shows off your creativity. Like for instance, like Drama. Like Drama got a clean ass fucking hand. That shit is clean. You feel what I'm saying? Rasad, he got a clean ass fucking hand. Like that shit is, and it stand out. You feel what I'm saying? Like writers that stand out, it's like creative to me, you feel what I'm saying? Like So Bad and, you know, ADS. Like boys like that, when they stand out because their hand is clean. You feel what I'm saying? It's creative. My man Rasan, like I went on a ride with Rasan before and I never really realized that he bring his S over to cross his A. You feel what I'm saying? So that's creative to me. You feel what I'm saying? I'm still trying to get sharp. Like it's always a practice. Every day is a practice. I can't say I mastered it. I mastered it to my little LR, but I got a whole name, Lehigh Rock. I ain't even mastered that yet. I ain't even throw that up yet. So it's like, I'm always practicing. Like my squad is a Whip City Specialist. You know, it's like a North Philly thing for real, you feel what I'm saying? Like Whip City Specials and the Whip City Hustlers. Like you got Norm, BM, Zart, B, Sank, Sneeze, B. Like we got that whip, you feel what I'm saying? And it's like, you had to earn your spot in our group. If you didn't have that whip, like you wouldn't be a part of our group. You feel what I'm saying? It's like we specialists, as you can see. You feel what I'm saying? Like I'm a fucking specialist. You feel what I'm saying? I do this shit for real. I can write backwards. I can top to bottom, bogeys, whatever. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna do when I get up to the wall. I just do it. I'm gonna fuck this shit up. Like, that's on my mind. Like, I'm just gonna just fuck this whole neighborhood up real fast. So, like, me personally, I like going to other writers' neighborhoods. I'm just writing my shit up where other writers live at. So soon they walk out their door, they see my shit like that. LR came through. That's what's up. Like, a stopcat spools a lot of writers. You feel what I mean? Like, I done seen writers throw their shit up on the wall with a stopcat and that shit look sloppy, but they throw in a fat cap and that shit be decent. Like, you should be able to write with any type of cap there is. I'm Black Book King for real. I think I'm in everybody's black book that's in the city for real. You feel what I'm saying? And I got my own books in the house, and I'm just constantly writing it all over my house. Just writing. Anytime I see a piece of paper got a pen near me, I'm writing.
Spoke. S-P-O-K-E. Spoke. Like the rims on a bike. Like bike spokes. Spokes. Spoke. Spoke. That's one of my backup names. Yeah. Alright, I really write Peka though. P-E-K-A. I'm about to hit some shit. charges. Wicked. VHS, vicious hand style.
As my big brother used to do. My brother, he got me into it as a young child. I see his shit, and from there I was doing that shit. Back in the day, 5 or 6 years old. South Philly, North Philly, West Philly, Northeast, West Philly, and shit. Hit up down Allegheny and shit back in the day, bombing for the Puerto Rican parade. Hitting the walls up for the parade and shit. In 2000, 2G, I bust out with Peka at the parade. All on the factory on American Street, P-E-K-A, and I wrote 2G. I did that in 2G. I used to go bombing with Dare in 2001. Then 02, I just ripped the game everywhere. That shit was everywhere. Everybody was loving it. Everybody was loving it. I was piecing, I was painting trains and shit, freight trains. I get some, I seen my shit on the internet. I ran into my boy Rem, man. Shout out to my man Rem, ATC. Yeah, that's my young boy. Second shoot. I had the whole second shoot on lock. The whole Lehigh on, you know, the whole Allegheny on lock. Me and the Dia. P, E, like a cursive E. Down, K, right there. A, that's the A right there. That's the A, that's the K, that's the E, and that's the P.
West Philly, DHS. Actually, my man Calf gave that shit to me like in the mid-90s, like 94. I was like struggling to find a graph writing name. Me and him was just sitting around fucking in the books one day. He just came up with Dramas, like write that. So I just ran with it. Being from West Philly in the Southwest area, Razlaw 1 was graffiti. Like, if it wasn't for Raz, rest in peace, I wouldn't probably even be writing today. He had plenty of rooftops. He killed shit. And even before I looked at the walls, he killed shit in the 80s and shit. So, yeah, Raz, like ICP cats, you know, they did fill-ins in the street, like colorful pieces in the street, like So Bad, SN, J, Dave Ski. But as far as around my neighborhood, we had guys like Warm, Bay, Darn, Pill. All them guys was getting that shit in before me, and definitely a big influence to me. Number one, can control. It's a certain way you use a can, certain way your shit come out on a wall. You know, number two, is consistency. You gotta have a stamp, which means, you know, your regular tag you put up everywhere, that shit gotta be consistent, you know what I mean? Yeah, that's pretty much it, man. Just the can control, you know, consistency, And you know, always get your stamp before you're wicked, man. Always get a stamp before wicked. I'm a hood writer, you know what I mean? You gotta come through the hood, first and foremost. But at the end of the day, rep is rep. However you get it, you know, that it's fine with me. But my thing is the hood. You come through the hood, you know, you write on a bunch of shit, you do some fills, and that's about it. But the rooftops is all good, you know what I mean? I'm not a climbing motherfucker, but I respect that shit. The tunnels is the shit, but niggas should stay away from the tunnels, man, because it's some old shit down there. It's like 60 years of Philadelphia graffiti history down there, and motherfuckers just going down there and going over shit. So stay away from the tunnels, man. And I don't know, rep, man, it's just however you get it. You know what I mean? I don't have a problem with however you get it. Highway spots, rooftops, hood shit, tunnels. Shit, you can write on the fucking ground. If I see it, you know what I mean? I'll tell you I seen your shit on the fucking ground. Like, you know what I mean? Honestly, it's a big stress relief for me. No matter what's going on in my life, you know, negative, positive, whatever, I could come out, get some tags, and not even think about that shit. All I be thinking about is getting my name up and seeing that shit everywhere I go. You know what I'm saying? It just makes me not think about all the negative shit that's going on in my life.
All right, Oban, NSBTMH. Well, I got into Graff because of my older brother. I seen him doing it when I was younger. You should see his shit around a lot. So I kind of wanted to get into it, see what it was about. Then I picked up a can probably like 09. Got into it a little bit, really wasn't taking it too serious. Started talking it serious when I came home back in like 2012. Then like I noticed all the love in it. You mean the fame, different hand styles, a lot of shit you can do with this. And then I just took it upon like I wanted to make something out of it, make a name for myself. So that's what I went out and did. Started killing shit, going routes, in spots, you mean, whatever it took to get noticed. Came up with Oban, pretty much because of my name, which I'm not gonna say, you mean, but I got it from my name. I mean, a lot of different meanings to it. Original badass nigga, you mean, one badass nigga. Oban, just, it was it for me. I like O's, you mean, way you could whip it. It's just perfect fit for me. I don't know other way to explain it. Me coming up in the game, the main niggas I seen like on the walls, on my fair shit would be XO, Toto. I mean, I'm from Kensington area, so that was like, if you from around here, that's like the main heads. Poe, meaning a couple of ESC dudes, OAL. I mean, a lot of different crews, but that was the top dogs. XO, you see XO on basically every rooftop. Still got shit running down here from like 8-10 years ago, probably longer than that. I was like, that was my inspiration. He was killing it. Pretty much you couldn't go through any little neighborhood around Kensington without seeing his shit. My favorite thing about bombing his spots is the rush. I mean, getting in and out of places without even being seen. Fucking up a whole neighborhood with nobody even noticing me. Then the next morning, everybody like, yo, you came through my hood. You fucked this up, fuck that up. You mean, certain neighborhoods I know I don't even fit in or belong in. And I go through there, do my thing. Then it's just mad love I get from it. It's my favorite thing. Like, it's the rush, I mean, if I ever do end up getting chased or whatever, the way I get away, what I do, you mean? How many styles I could put up, how many throws I could, you mean, do in the night, straight letters. Whatever, like, I try to get away with much as possible. It's a stress reliever for real, too. Like, I mean, you ever mad, arguing with your bitch, whatever, you go out, you do a crazy route, blows a lot of your stress out. You ain't even thinking about anything no more. You just worrying about what you're doing, your surroundings, and how much shit you can do. Like, that's my whole thing. I like to pull more shit than any other nigga can. Like, I try to do more than what they did in their whole career in one night. Tall hands and straight letters. You could do a lot of different things with tall hands. You could whip it different ways. Basically, any hand style I like for real, but my favorite would be tall hands. Because it pretty much shows who you are, how your print is. Is you different or is you blocking, you mean? You dicking the nigga. And straights is like, you could do so much with one thing. You could switch it up so many ways, or where you blending the colors in together. Or the way, you mean, you fuck up a whole different neighborhood with different hand styles. Wicked, like, plain print hands, like. It's just, not a lot of people could really sit there and, you mean, come up with their own style. The way you whip it, you mean, your fades, not a lot of people know how to fade. You mean, a lot of different shit to it. Shit is cans. I like, you mean, I don't like having little cut tags. I want my shit to be seen, you mean? Be right in the nigga's face. Well, what stands out to me when I look at Graff, when I'm like strolling through a hood or whatever, would be the differences. Noticing like the shit that's different, not like everybody else shit. Like, if you got your own style, it's just gonna pop. It's not gonna be like every other nigga out here. You mean, it's either dicking off of somebody else's style, or you mean whatever it is that they doing. My shit is like, you got your own shit. Shit makes you stand out. Shit could be a little whack. As long as you got your own style, you gonna get recognition. Like, as long as you ain't biting nobody's shit, you mean, you doing your own thing, I give you all respects. Shit, that's how, you mean, that's pretty much Graff to me.
What's going on? This is Krev, you know what I mean? K-R-E-V, Krev Don, Krever, whatever. You know what I mean? But where the name came from? Well, man, I had that name for years. I was a young boy. I wasn't even in middle school when I came up with that name. I just liked the letters. But what it stands for is Cool Radical Everlasting Vandal. You know what I mean? I always believed in Graff, you had to be radical. You had to be different from everybody else and do crazy shit. Me personally, I feel as though I ain't go all ham or like that, all crazy doing radical shit. Cause I had a lot of events in my life that forced me to like stop the Graff a little bit. You know what I mean? I still got love for it though. I mean, you could get your name just looking at something, you know what I mean? You know, nicknames. When you come up with a name, you gotta come up with something that is original, first of all. And that nobody else wrote before. That's the way I believe. I'm from the old school. And also, you know what I mean? The name that you pick is gonna represent you. So, you know, there's nobody with that name Krev, so I'm original with it. I think the cat is like King, Philly for real, that's everybody's favorite legend. You know what I mean? You gotta respect old heads like that, Cat, Far. I mean, a lot of writers that did it, man. There's so many writers out there, I could go on all day. You know, there's a lot of writers out there that's hot. I just like anything that's original, to be honest. Like, I sound like a broken record, but originality is the key. Me, I always like the wickets. My wickets, it's me. I try to be different. I try to be original. You know what I mean? I make my wickets so people can see me do a wicket and they can probably follow the pattern. But when they try to duplicate, it's not going to look the same. And one thing about me is like, no one could do the wickets the way I do. Not saying that I'm the best in the world, the best in Philly, but I can feel confident that people can't duplicate it. And if you can't duplicate my hand, then, or you do some type of version of it, then, you know, I know it's not original. You know what I'm saying? So that's how I look at it, you know? I just try to be humble with it, man, you know, that's all. Yeah, I mean, I prefer Stolium. I used to like Krylon back in the days, Spavar. A lot of people don't even know what Spavar is. Spavar used to be a brand of paint that we used to fuck shit up. Hot paint for the chrome. You know, I just keep it Rusto. I like Rust-Oleum, flat black, flat white. You know what I mean? That's what I like. But you could tell, you know, it also by the hands, you know, by the flow, how they, you know, how they whip it. I mean, they fades, evenness when they do their wickets, you know. Well, I always had a strong art upbringing. My mom was real good with arts and crafts. My oldest brother used to draw. I was good drawing myself. So, you know, I started when I was young drawing like comic books and characters, comic characters, and I always tried to make my own characters and superheroes and shit. And just graph. I was dealt with paints, markers and shit like that, so I just started just being around the neighborhood where I grew up at, and a lot of my homies was writing, and I just started fucking shit up. It's cool to be inspired by people. It's cool to be a fan of somebody's styles and hands. You know, if I believe everybody gets inspired, everybody writes somewhat similar to someone that they grew up liking. I was inspired by a lot of writers coming up too. It's okay to be inspired. But don't take somebody's shit and their style, even if you don't even know the writer, ever met the writer. Or if the writer that you like or you grew up looking up to didn't personally give you hands or some shit, don't bite his style, be original. Regardless how much you like the person, how you influence the person. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I grew up in an era that, you know, you could come up with a name. But if you do a certain letter, even one letter or an arrow or a star that look like another writer, then people will consider that you biting or you took that shit off of them. So I grew up in an era when it was graph, when you was forced to be original, be different. And that helped me to be different. You doing my wickets, and, you know? Some of my wickets, it's easy for people to see, and some wickets, they don't know what the fuck I wrote, but I know what I wrote, and I know it's me. And be original, that's it.
That's that fire right there, boy. That shit right there. That's that shit right there. That's where niggas got these styles.
Nixer, N-I-X-E-R. Most of the time you'll see me write Nix, N-I-X. I always did look at graph, and you know, I was kinda the kid, always drawing shit, so you know, honestly what happened one day, I was at work, I looked inside the cleaning closet, I seen some cans, so I said, you know what, I'ma just try this shit. So I walked from, matter of fact, my first route. I walked like 15 blocks from my job and just started hitting shit. I said, you know, I like this shit, and started from there. It was a game. I don't know if y'all play games. I like playing games. It was a game called Infamous 2. So my nephew liked playing it. I was playing it with him. So it was a character on there with the name. And her power, she had like a fire power. She liked destroying shit. I said, you know what? I like her character. I said, I like destroying shit. So I said, you know what? I'ma use that. So I looked at her name, said N-I-X. I said, all right, I want that. Let me get that. Took it, started flowing with it, and went from there. Stuff that I think about when I'm hitting or I'm doing anything graph-wise, period, is I want this shit to last. I want somebody to see this shit, and I want to try to put as much perfection in it as possible, because you know how you write, what you write, is you labeling yourself. Like a company label themselves and they do all this and third, it's the same thing for you. So it's like, if I got some paint, I'm hitting a wall. I don't sit there and think about as far as like how I'm gonna do it, but in my mind, and then like how everything's moving, I want to do the best I can. Like I want as much perfection that can come out as possible, because at the end of the day, somebody gonna see this shit. And I want somebody to see this shit, especially since compared to most writers, I'm new. Like I got 2 years experience at most. I want somebody to see this shit and be like, you know what? I like him. I see what he trying to do. You know, that shit is flowing, especially to be a new nigga. The stuff that I like is the shit that, it might sound weird, I like the corny shit. People be like, why do you like the corny shit? Cause sometimes we like, all right, say like, you see a writer that's established, like you might see like Karma, Rashawn, they hands is nice, they established, they been out. I like looking at corny hands because sometimes like you can look and see like where they trying to go. I like looking at people's potential. I like seeing like, basically I like seeing new niggas pop up. Now, I like seeing new niggas pop up because for the simple fact, they got potential.
What's going on, fellas?
Going on?
Shooting a music video.
Yeah, you're part of it. So what's up?
Nice. You guys seen kids around here spray painting or nah? Nah, you guys ain't call about it? Alright, just making sure. Check it out, you fellas.
Yeah.
Yeah, I told you though.
Told you that bitch stitch.
Mm-hmm. It's cool. But we ain't doing shit.
All right, Brdoe. It's pronounced Brdoe. BRD for short. I actually started writing probably back in like 94. I used to write Brace. But this is black dude I don't know about. And ATP, he was in prison the whole time. And that was his tag. And no one ever told me. And I went away for 8 years almost altogether. When I came home, my man Rame told me. So I switched up my shit, and for the, like, the last year, I just been going as hard as I can. Most definitely Darrow, you know, Zell, dude named Andy, Harwan, and, you know, Darrow himself from AIA. Praise Sat, Omac, Catism. You know, I like to like switch it all up. Like, you know, straight letters to lower cases. Like all different types of styles. But definitely like tall hands is definitely my favorite. I mean, I'll write in the daytime, in the nighttime, I'll write anytime. If there's something to write on, I'm gonna write on it. As long as it ain't someone's like house and shit, you know? I'm about to draw that. My man here was, he climbed up on, trying to get on this roof to get onto the L. Now I knew I wasn't gonna be able to get the fuck up it. But he's like Spider-Man and shit. So,
he was Spider-Man that time, bro.
He climbed up onto the concrete wall and stuck his finger in these edges and tried to pull himself up. And he dropped about 2 stories down onto the grass. I thought the motherfucker was like, broke his leg at least. I was knocked out. I came over and he was just like, oh.
Oh,
MS1, IYA. Man, I've been doing this since 97. All day, ever since I've been in grade school, 97. I had to put it down when I went to the Army, but I'm back. Coming back, 2014. Well, back when I was writing MEK, it was just like, all right, what combination of letters can you put together that you can write the best? So that's what I did, and then I started seeing MB, you know, Mr. Brooks and shit, and then that's what inspired me to write MS. So that's pretty much how it all started. And when I was in grade school, me and my cousin, we got up with these dudes, KBR and Meth. They used to go to school with us, you know, showed us a couple things. I used to write MEK back in the day. He used to write AOR, RIP Vic, D-Star. So, you know, my cousin's dead now, but yeah, that's how the beginning started, man. Back in the 90s, going to school and shit, just doing the shit. Going to the fucking auto store, stealing bumper paint. So, you know how it goes, racking paint. You just gotta have swag, man. It's gotta be original. I mean, they talk about Philly hands, you know, this and that. For me, it's just originality. Of course, you know, my style developed from being from here, but it's all about originality. It's whatever you wanna put out, and your art is, that's what it's gotta be.
Edub. Well, I started writing because my pop, I mean, he used to tag back in the days, so I used to see his name through the neighborhood, you know what I mean, he used to hit me up like, yeah, you see that. So, you know, when I used to pass through his neighborhood, you know what I mean, catch little tags so he could see it. But when I started, I started by myself. I didn't really know too many cats, you know what I mean, it was just something that I did, you know what I mean, just walking by, I used to like seeing my name everywhere. And after that, you know what I mean, once I got into it, I started meeting some of the old heads like Men, I met Sir, Rame, then just the streets, and I lived down north, so, you know what I mean, it was all in the walls around me. When I first started, I didn't have a hand style or nothing, I was just trying to get my name up. I was more worried about the cops and people seeing me. So once I passed all that, that's when I started to develop style, you know what I mean, I met a couple cats, they showed me a couple hands and stuff like that. I just took that and ran with it. I like mops, because you can fit more in your pocket. But other than mops, cans, and etch, you know, for the windows. I had the name probably since I was like 11 years old. I used to write Joker, but my old head gave me the name E-Double. That's where it originally come from. So everybody used to be like, oh yeah, I see you, double, I see you. And I was like, I don't know why I'm writing Joker, everybody calling me double. So it just started at that. Now it never stopped, now I just shortened it to double. And then I felt like that was too long, so I just shortened it to E-Dub. I used to see Kane, Rain, Rasan, Bleed. That's when that whole, I think, KMD and ATB, beef is going on. So that really inspired, you know what I mean? I was like, damn, these niggas is killing this shit. Like, nobody must be watching them. So, you know what I mean? I just picked up a can and just kept trying. Being original. I mean, you learn from somebody. I mean, somebody might give you something, but, you know what I mean? Start building off that. Like, try to put your own personality to it, I mean, your own creation. You gotta make it different from everybody else. I like trying different stuff. The piecing and throwies I had, because I was always into art, so it kind of came like a little easier for me. But hands is something I really had to work on. It took me like at least 2 years, and over like $1,000.
I write Timski, I'm from North Philadelphia. I rep NSB, SC squad. Well, my uncle, he used to bomb back in the day, like in the 80s. And when I grew up, he kind of told me about it, like, look, I used to tag, me and your pop used to go out crazy bombing. So that made me want to get into it. So when he passed away last year. So when he passed away, I just want to continue the legacy. Graffiti man. Graffiti, it means a lot to me. Like, a lot of people in the hood don't have a lot of things, and graffiti is one of the things that I got that I could tell people, like, look, I'm good at this. This right here, this is a high school I go to, this El Centro de Estudiantes. This right here is a high school for people who don't do good in regular high school, so this is like a second chance for them. And right here, I had to hassle them a little bit about doing this, but I actually got one right over here. It took me like maybe 2 weeks to get the paint and all that, and to let them allow me to do it, but this is one of the first murals I ever did. So Centro de Estudiantes, Art Primo, that's where we got the paint from. A piece goes over a throw up. There's a major difference. A throw up is something you throw together real fast just to get your name there and to get it bold. When you're talking about a piece, you're talking about something you do on the side of a store, or something you do like on the train tracks when you got time. A throw up is real quick, 2 minutes, real quick, fill that in, outline, that's it. But a piece is where you take your time, you try to get all the right angles, colors, all of that. Everybody gotta start from tagging. I mean, that's how it goes out here. You start from tagging, you write your name somewhere because you think it's cool. It keeps on going, then you get proud of your name. After you get proud of your name, you want your name to look the best. So what you do is you take your time, you sketch out certain letters. You go online, a lot of people go online and look at letters. I'd rather just sketch out a letter. That'd be my personal letter. Nobody else using that letter but me. It's different, it's distinct. That's what a piece is, it's distinct to your name. I just seen a bunch of the bees, and that also persuaded me too. Like, just seeing a bee everywhere, I'm like, I wanna see Tim everywhere. I want people to talk about Tim and just be like, bull shirt.
Grimis, for short, GMS. I've been writing off and on for like at least like 15 years. Wanted to write something that I knew nobody else was gonna write, because I came up with a few names as a young boy coming up. There was a lot of old head writers who wrote other shit, so they wound up taking them names. Had to stop writing them, didn't have as much rep with the name. So I wanted to write something that I knew nobody else was gonna be able to bite, steal, or nothing like that, as it was there. Something original. And I was a fat boy growing up as a young boy, so one of the characters from McDonald's was Grimace. I liked the name and it stuck with it. And it was a different name, something I never heard before. So I wound up sticking with that. Bumped into my man Gia in high school, and he told me just for hands, he was like, cut it short down just to GMS. Makes it a little easier. I'm not there catching a hand for 12 seconds when I could knock it out in 5. So that's when GMS came up. The ones is just something I'd add extra because it flows with. Just seeing other people, like seeing like care from IYA, crush on the LVU, seeing niggas just have hands around, seeing motherfuckers do legal spots, just seeing the different colors, the art aspect of it, the street, the hood aspect of it, the fact, just the adrenaline rush, the fact that you didn't get caught, you know you ain't supposed to be doing this shit, but you still do it. It's an art form, it's kind of like a way of life. It's something that you could do to say, I could fuck this whole city up. Fuck everybody, you can eat a dick at the end of the day. Catch me if you can. As soon as that paint touched the wall, it's whatever comes to mind. Unless I already got something planned out. just hearing the city around you, hearing them squeaky brakes, things that sound like vans, people walking by, newsy neighbors that can't mind their business. You get a lot of chase stories out of that. Some you get away from, some you just don't. When I first look at graffiti on the wall, whether it's a wicked, a hand, a tall hand, even just a hollow, a throw, a fill, whatever, I look at first and foremost the spot. The spot says it all. Whenever you're hitting the spot is what the spot tells you you're able to do. If it's a small cramp spot, you gotta go small cramp. But the spot says it all first. The flares on a hand, that's my favorite part of a hand. Just whatever color paints you use, rustles, you know what I mean? You have some belt ones or whatnot, but fills is something totally different. Fills is just something that catches your eye, your color schemes, your letter structure, what your color scheme was, how big you go, did you go too small? Like, different aspects of it. I love taking routes. It shows you that, I mean, I'm 31 and I'm still catching hands in the street. Most dudes is just only doing legals, or only doing stuff that they don't have to run from if anything jumps off. But I'm still here in the streets catching these hands. I mean, that's one of my favorite throws. I love to do throws. You know, from that, I just jump straight to burners and do some pieces or whatever the case is. But love going on routes. I say my favorite thing for real to do is just throws and hands, wickets. Graffiti is putting yourself on the wall, getting your rep, hitting shit, fucking shit up, showing your progression, you know, getting better throughout the years, not giving a fuck, doing stuff that other people won't do, hitting that spot that everybody talks about hitting, but nobody got the heart to do it. You know what I mean? Just putting yourself out there, expressing yourself, having people look at you, having motherfuckers that don't even know you, but they know you because they see your name throughout their city. You could be their favorite writer. They can't do graffiti themselves. They might never even meet you, but they know you.
But if it's in you and it's something that you really want to do and it's something that you're really about and it's part of your lifestyle, it's something that if you're out painting 7 days a week or if you're out painting once, if you don't paint for a couple of years and you just come out and catch a few hands and get your rep back up a little bit, doesn't matter. If it's in you, it's you. Just stick with it. Take your time. Have patience. Progression will come. Patience is something that you gotta have because it's gonna take a long time to come.
Entro. All right, Entro, from Frankfurt. I wrote like three different things from third grade up until about freshman year of high school. I originally wrote it with an I, and I put the E on it for style. I've been writing that since 2007. Originally, I seen it on the trains going on regional rail when I was going to New York, and it just pulled me in from there. Things that inspired me was big, bold, in your face with tons of colors. L views, 95 views. Regional rail views, the 100-foot long straight letters. Favorite thing to paint is a straight letter. Throws is cool, but ain't nothing like a straight letter. You know, for people painting 20 years, I can't do a box letter, soft edges, hard edges. Piecing, that's dope, but that ain't what I do. I'm into straight letters. My favorite spots to paint are either in your face or off in the distance. You know, somewhere you won't usually expect to see something. Big bold and in your face. You know, I won't paint somewhere that's always getting consistent. I'd rather hit a fresh spot. When I look at somebody's straights, the thing that gets me is when they clean up. When they touch up their work, you know, make their outline a lot sharper than it is. And then there's people that don't even need to, you know, clean their work up. They do their points and they're pointing. You know, they're not round, they're not sloppy, they're not dripping. Hands, I love flares, you know. Fountain flared hands. And you flick your wrist, or just let the can fade up or down, or sideways, and you drag it off the wall. While I'm on the wall, I'm actually at peace. You know, I really don't worry about much. You know, like a lot of people worry about the cops, you know, people yelling, you know, worrying about looking out. When I finally get my eyes on the wall, I'm calm, cool, and collected. You know, take your time, do your book work. You know, don't diss nobody. Don't look for respect or fame, it'll come to you.
Ray Los, NSB. I like Graff because people see your name everywhere, but nobody knows who you are. Graff-wise, growing up, I like Tracy 168 from New York, Wild Style. Moving to Philly, I really like NM. NM did his shit a lot. Oz, you got King Care. Graff, I think hands is the first most important thing. You can't skip hands. You just gotta do your hands. You gotta know how to wicked do what you do. I ain't have a hand until about last year, probably, I think so. I ain't like my hands at all till about last year. I think I wouldn't have known none of the stand-up dudes I know right now if it wasn't for graffiti. My mom hates this shit. My mom hates seeing my name around. You just gotta be original. Stay in those books before you fuck these walls up. You gonna get judged forever for that. You gotta stay original, think about your name. Watch where you hit, follow the rules.
Keech from South Philly. Keech came from just a nickname growing up in South Philly. Everybody's got some kind of nickname, whether you got it from your last name being Italian, food you ate, the neighborhood you grew up in, anything. Everybody always had a nickname. Just came basically from my last name. My boy gave it to me. What made me pick up the can? I just loved it. Loved graffiti from the beginning. My sister's old boyfriend back in the day put me into this mostly, taught me the ropes. Shout out to him for creating a monster. And that was it, man. That's probably early, mid 80s maybe. Just always loved it, riding down the highway, seeing graffiti in the neighborhood, on the schools, and everywhere. I just a fan of it, man. I was hooked instantly. Just being a fan and wanting to do it made me pick up a can, made me just start drawing and learning the craft, graffiti. When I came back in, started writing again, probably like 2010 maybe. All the walls were pretty much bombed. Made me grab a pole and a roller, trying to go high, avoiding beefs and avoiding craft beef and bullshit. So I just kind of switched it up to the rollers. That became my thing. I mean, I still love my cans, I love painting, but now it seems like I became the roller dude. Being creative, doing what you want to do, doing whatever feels right. There's no real right or wrong with it. On the highway, I remember seeing JC, J-A-Y-C-E-E. He had a lot of pieces on the highways. That was the first thing I noticed. That was actually my initials, so I was like, man, I want to do that, I want to do this. But then, you know, as you got older, I mean, you know, Oz was a huge Philly name, Care, I mean, there were so many dudes, ADS, when graffiti was alive in the, you know, 80s to early 90s, there were so many that stood out, hand styles, and, you know, there was pieces, rooftops. It would be too many people to say who stood out, really. Just shout out to everybody who's doing it and doing it, you know, whatever they want to do. Do what you feel is right. Right now it seems to be the rollers, just because I could get in my funky spots. I could get in the crazy spots, so I would say I choose rollers right now for my medium. I could get in high, I could hang off a building, get a pole, get a longer pole, and get them spots and make people say, how the fuck did he do that, or how the hell is that even possible? That's what I kind of go for. So right now, pick rollers as my medium. As I drive by stuff, any kind of graffiti really catches my eye. I mean, I'll catch a marker hand if I'm doing 40 miles an hour on the highway. I just respect it all, man. I respect, if I seen it, I respect it, because dude or the girl went out and did it, put it up, and I seen it, so it stands out. And I just respect everybody, man. Nobody doing it wrong or right. If you're out there doing it, I respect you in my eyes. Depends where I'm at. If I'm doing a legal wall, it's, you know, I'm in chill mode, it's a lot different. I mean, if I'm out painting illegal, the idea is to just make it home and kill that spot, get it done in time. Make it at home is my key when I'm out. My favorite spot I did was a building. It got buffed. It was on 95 in South Philly area. I did a big ass Keech roller, two colors, and I did a big cancer ribbon. And across the top, I wrote "Save the Tatas." And I was kind of really mad that they buffed it in like 2 months, because it took a long fucking time, man. And it was a good piece for a good cause. The advice I would give would be, learn your history. Everybody's got to learn your history, especially if you're coming from Philly. Learn your history before you paint a wall. It's important.
My team. The young boys that are buzzing around North Philly. My uncle Aces, I don't know if he ever told you, or he will ever tell you, but I gave Aces his name. He's gonna kill me for this, and make sure that we run this by him before you actually do anything with it. But he was writing Sohn, and everybody knows he's an old Sohner. And everybody knows if you come out in the game and you have someone else's name, that you gotta be a little more crafty and come up with your own shit a little bit. I mean, I can't really say it, because I got a Krack Kills, but then you got Krack 7. That's the only other Krack I consider like a reputable Krack whatsoever. But I gave Aces his name, Aces. I thought that was a good name for the young boy, because he's the ace in the hole, you know? I was like, Kills is hot. I was like, Krack, I fuck with Krack, because everybody fucks around and calls me that, you know what I mean? So I just thought about, like, you could do Krack Kills, Krack Skulls, Krack Blunts, like, but every time I go to hit a wall and I try to switch it up a little bit, I forget, and I just end up doing the same thing over and over and over again. And I know everybody's probably tired of seeing the same stamp over and over and over again, but you know what? That's my fucking stamp, you know what I mean? So that's what it's gonna be, and you know who I am, so I gotta be doing something right, you know what I mean? But it's not a wicking for you guys, but I'm working on it, you know what I mean? I got my old head Zark trying to school me a little bit, and I'll forever be grateful for him taking the time out to try to school my dumb ass on how to do a wicked, you know what I mean? I started, like, obviously, just like every other kid, just messing around, following some people from New York. When I was younger, I used to live closer to New York City. Like, I grew up on New York City Graff. I didn't grow up on Philly Graff. I didn't grow up knowing what a wicked was. I didn't grow up knowing about none of that, you know what I mean? I originally was a follower of New York Graff, and just through the years, I ended up here through, like, that's a whole other story, through like some music and yada yada yada, I ended up in Philly. But I've been in Philly now for a good 20 years. And the first people to introduce me to anything in Philly was Karaz, Me-Rock, A-Rock, one of my best friends, Kep 575. These are the both that were around, like, since OK Corral. Like, they were, everybody knows who Karaz is, you know what I mean? These are like real Philly icons in North Philly, you know what I mean? This is anyway, they brought me around Philly, showed me around. I got to meet a lot of people over here, Hunting Park, down Erie, right here, everywhere. And everybody's brought me in and like took me under their wing. And here I am today, just trying to suck in as much knowledge and be as humble as possible and learn from everybody around me, because we all got our own twist to this, you know what I mean? It ain't about, in my opinion, it ain't about like everybody having a certain style of hand. It's about doing what you want to do to be creative and rep your shit and what you want to be known for. We don't gotta all be known for the same thing. Some people want to be known for different things, you know what I mean? So, I mean, I'm a big fan of the Philly style, Philly hands. I mean, I don't got the flow to really like, I'm too like with my type of shit. When other boys, like down here, obviously, they got this whole flow to them, you know what I mean? It's like magic when you watch somebody who knows how to put a real stamp on a wall, do what they gotta do. I mean, and I appreciate and just think it's dope, like how Philly has their own complete style. But then I also love like New York style, where you have real plain, real legible, one crazy letter that makes it like all come together, like you take your S, you flow it all the way around, if it, yada, 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 I mean. But I think just, I think everybody starts with it being not so hot, and obviously you work into, your stamp is who you kind of like, it represents you, you know what I mean? Like, and that's like, in its purest form, like it's basically like signing your license or something, or like government paperwork. See what this kid's doing right here? He's trying to support everybody. Everybody give him what, like, this is our chance to show Philly in its purest form, everybody. Let's get together and do it right, you know what I mean? Let's not like, let's make it about the walls, and that's it.